Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to the channel. So today we'll be doing a quick little tip on why we should be using dipoles instead of clover leaves for racing or for our quads. I know we've been using clover leaves for quite some time now, and while they have been good and they have been really nice for FPV to get through all the, you know, the clutter when we're flying around trees and everything, usually for racing, it's in an open field with just gates and flags in between, right? So, a bunch of my friends and myself have been using these little dipoles available from Banggood. We've been calling them snowman antennas. I don't know why they were calling them snowman antennas. I just kind of picked up on the name. So, these little antennas are basically dipoles wrapped in the little rubbery material from a rubber ducky, like similar to the VTX antennas. I'm sorry, the antennas that you get free with a VTX. And if you strip them down, it's basically this one, right? So it's a dipole with a SMA connector or RPSMA connector. We've been using them on our 5-inch quads for racing because, like I said, when racing, it's usually an open field with just gates and flags thrown in between. So, up to 5 quads, we've been trying them out, and for a few months now, we've been getting really nice feedback, and including myself, I've been noticing that there is no need for a clover leaf antenna for a race quad. I mean, for racing. Because a clover leaf, if you don't mount correctly, usually gets caught in a gate, or, you know, gets clipped off when you smash your quad into a gate, and it, you know, flies off into the grass or anything, something like that. With these small dipoles, hopefully it focuses, okay? With these really small dipoles, they're so small, usually when you put it on a quad, this is my 5-inch snipe, it sticks out here from the VTX, okay? As you can see, it's really small, so when your frame hits the ground or a gate, the frame hits the ground and the antenna doesn't really come into contact with the ground or the gate itself because it's so small. So it's well protected. I've never damaged one of these in, I don't know, maybe four or five months of flying around with this race quad. It's so small, like I said, and the weight saving, obviously, compared to a clover leaf, even though it's the one of the really small clover leaves that come out right now, this is still lighter, a lot lighter. So yeah, like I said, I'll be posting DVR clips of this quad and a couple of other quads of mine using these dipoles, so you can see for yourself if, you know, there's a trade-off, there's a small degradation in the video quality signal. But it's not much, and it's perfectly flyable, especially for racing. So, like I said, I'll post a DVR, some DVR clips, and you can judge for yourself and see how these dipoles can, you know, save you some money and save you some grams for your quad. All right, if you like this video, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Thanks, you guys. If you like this video, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Thanks, you guys.